Hello, today we are going to study DREF3, which is subclassified under the false twist spinning process. And it is just an extension of DREF2, if you remember. So before we go further, let us just try to revise false twist principle. We already know this. The first arrangement inserts false real twist, whereas these two arrangements show how a false twist is inserted. If the clamps are not moving, it's a rigid clamp, then the false twister would put equal and opposite turns on both the sides of the false twister. Whereas in the second case, as the yarn moves, as soon as the material comes out of the false twister, it will have zero twist. So with this background in mind and the background of DREF 2, let us see how DREF 3 works. So this is the yarn passage for DREF 3 or DREF 3000, which, as I already mentioned, is subclassified under the false twist process. One here is the draw frame sliver, which is being fed. It is about 2.5 to 3.5 kilotex. You come to a drafting arrangement, which inserts a draft of around 100 to 150. The fiber strand comes out at the front roller of the drafting arrangement, and this strand now enters the perforated drum zone, which is numbered 4 here. Now what you see is staple fibers are being fed perpendicular to the nip of the perforated drum, and this set of staple fibers comes from a different drafting arrangement, which might be somewhere above. 6 here is the bundled yarn, the output that we get here, and 7 is the takeoff rollers. So now what we see here in the arrangement is this. For the time being, let us imagine that this set of staple fibers is not being fed, and this particular strand fiber this draw frame fiber coming from this drafting arrangement is entering the region of the perforated drum, and this perforated drum would be like a false twister, and these are the two set of rollers, the front roller of the drafting system, and this 7, which is the takeoff rollers. Both of them would act like the arrangement which we just saw in false twist principle. So with this false twister in between, what would happen is the material here between the front roller and the perforated drum nip here, the material would have some twist in a certain direction depending on the direction of rotation of these perforated drums. But as soon as the material comes out, according to the false twist principle, what you see is there would be no twist inserted here. That is, all the twist would be opened out and there would be no twist in this particular strand of fibers. Now, if nothing else was done, suppose this was what the arrangement was, you would get no yarn here as an output. But now what we are doing actually is we are feeding this set of fibers, 5, which is coming from a different drafting arrangement, and this set of staple fibers which come will be falling on the nip of the perforated drum, and these fibers would wrap the first set of fibers. They will, if for example, if you remember DREF 2 spinning, there was no drafting arrangement here. It was only these set of fibers which were twisted, and what you would get is a final yarn. So same thing would be happening here, but only difference being that this set of fibers would be wrapping themselves on the first set of fibers that are coming in this direction. So what you get is a bundled yarn where the core is formed by this first set of fibers. They would be lying straight, and the second set of fibers, whatever you feed from at 5 here, would be forming the cover, and these would be having some real twist on it. So what you get, we also know how a bundled yarn looks like. So what you get out as an output is a bundled yarn. And this particular yarn is then taken up and wound onto a suitable package. So this is how actually the machine would look like. Now, what are the kind of raw materials that can be spun? It has been found that this machine, being very gentle in its operation, all kinds of fibers can be spun, even those which were found to be difficult to be spun on other spinning systems, even ring frame at times. So fibers like aramid and carbon fibers can be spun on DREF 3. Polyester and polyamide fibers are often used in the core, and cotton is used as an envelope. So this is an interesting combination where we will have the strong fibers in the core, and the comfortable fibers, which is similar to cotton, would be the envelope which would be on the surface. So what you get is a yarn which is comfortable for feel, and at the same time would possess enough or higher strength as compared to a normal cotton yarn. The proportion of the envelope fibers can usually range from 15 to 60% due to the fact that the core and the wrapping fibers are fed from separate sources. Here, instead of fibers, you can also use filaments in the core of the fineness ranging from 0.6 to 6.7 dtx. And these could be bound into the core to produce core yarns. So almost all kind of imaginable yarns can be spun, and such yarns could have interesting applications in technical textiles, because we can spin the difficult ones over here, and you can have a lot of combination of various fibers that you could have in the entire yarn structure. So quite an interesting process. As we have already seen, this is just an extension of DREF 2 spinning, where there was no core. So when you come to the specification, spinning positions were 3 to 24, delivery speed 250 meters per minute. Raw material that you use is cotton and synthetic fibers. Both can be used. The count range, again, as you can see, it is in the coarse count range. Feedstock is draw frame sliver. The type of yarn that you get is a bundled yarn. And yarn characteristics, you have few envelope fibers, if there are few envelope fibers, you would get a yarn of ring spun yarn character. And if you use more envelope fibers, that is number 5 that was shown in the diagram, if there are more envelope fibers that you are feeding, then you would get a yarn character similar to that of a rotor spun yarn. This rotor spun yarn we are yet to study, it will come later. So field of use would be home textiles, sports, leisure clothing, outerwear, technical products, to mention it's a special application. Then advantages are, again, which is common to all alternate spinnings almost, that is elimination of process stages. And remarks for this particular spinning system, it is a simple production process. So when you come to the industrial impact, so or rather how it has impacted the industry because of this kind of process that we can make specialty yarns. And yarns are made from unusual fibers. You can make composite yarn with special core or sheet structure. Yarns with special properties can be made, which could be used in protective textiles, which is again a technical application of textiles. DREF 3000 is therefore not a spinning process for mass production, but an interesting and successful system for niche market where special tailor-made yarns are required. So in case of speciality yarns, DREF 3000 is a very successful spinning process. The only drawback, if at all you can see, is that it is coming in the coarse count region. Otherwise, this is a very interesting way of producing some special yarns out of this, using this particular system. So we come to this chart again, and we have completed false twist process. And as you can see, DREF 3, it's an extension of DREF 2, which was just an open-end spinning process. Now you know why it is regrouped under false twist, because the drum acts like a false twister for the core fibers that we feed. So although it is under the spinning process, it is still friction spinning, it will come under the false twist process. And the commercial name is DREF 3, and it will give you a bundled single yarn. just like Murata Airjet. And core, it's the same description, core twist free and wrapping fibers have twist. And yarn strength is imparted by using perforated drums, and therefore it is a mechanical twisting or wrapping process, or yarn strength is imparted by mechanical means. So we come to the end of this particular lecture. Thank you very much.